Hello po, ma'am.
Yan, narinig po ba ako?
Yes po, loud and clear po.
Kita na rin po ba yung PowerPoint?
Yes po, yes po.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes po, yes po.
Thank you. Good morning once again to our partners and girls at saka yung mga kasama natin sa College of Business, Economics, and Entrepreneurship. So, as Ma'am Galicia had introduced, no, so we will be discussing about communication. So, narinig nyo kanina yung Filipino brand of service excellence kay Sir Fern and Sir Marvy and sanitation and safety from Ma'am Lou and Ma'am Glenda. So, as you can see, they're all about developing our personalities in the professional field, ano? So, of course, lalo na sa panahon ngayon na we are always talking about technology, di ba? Lalo na sa communication, di ba? Hindi tayo nawawala sa ating mga cellphones, lalo na yung mga kabataan yun. However, it has been noticed na sa generation ngayon, parang nawawala na yung courtesy natin when it comes to using our cell phones, no? Nawawala din yung courtesy natin when it comes to either answering a professional call, a business call, or a personal call. So, this morning, we will be discussing sa inyo yung paano nga ba tayo properly mag-answer ng mga voice communications and non-voice. Ano ba yung mga considered as non-voice? Pwede yan through email, through chats, through the messaging apps, no? Ayan. But this morning, ang focus on the voice and tapos ang aking partner si Sir Aldrin. Gusto yata niya natatawag na Ma'am Liza. So, let us move on. Okay. So, paano nga ba? More often, we call this voice etiquette as telephone etiquette. No? Bakit ba napaka-importante that we are aware of proper telephone etiquette? So, sabi niya, first thing is, it reflects our professionalism, no? Kapag nakikita nila that you are practicing good telephone etiquette, nakikita nila, ah, professional to, marunong itong ano, kausap, and probably they will deliver better yung mga products and services namin dahil napaka-professional niya, no? I feel that your customers will feel safe if you are talking to them professionally, no? So, masasense nila yon of the way you talk to them. Diba? Parang, kunwari, tumawag ka, tapos ang sumagot sa'yo, oh, ano yun? Oh, diba? Parang, pag sagot mo pala, parang ayoko niya tang ituloy yung sasabihin ko, diba? Pero kung yung sumagot sa'yo, thank you for calling, how may I help you? Ganun ang sumagot, diba? Parang mas nafe-feel mo na you're in good hands. Diba? Okay. Next, sabi niya, it provides or makes the receiver feel respected, and this has it gives a good impression of you, not only that, but of all your company, especially for business calls, no? Since you are representing your company, at kung nagsalita ka at narinig nila na napaka-professional mo when you talk, no? Of course, they will have a better impression of you and your company, okay? What else? It builds loyalty and trust, especially to your potential customers. Kasi nakikita nila, ah, professional kausap ito, ah, reliable ito, ah, trustworthy ito. No? So more likely, you will also get their trust and confidence when it comes to your products and services. Ano pa? Of course, your customers will be more likely satisfied of your services kasi even through the phone pa lang, sa pag-inquire pa lang nila, maayos ka na makipag-usap sa kanila. Diba? So it shows them that their needs and requirements will be satisfied as in person as well. Kumbaga, sa phone pa lang, maayos ka ng kausap, na-deliver mo na yung mga inquiries nila, more likely that during the personal, pag nagkita-kita na kayo, especially when you do the actual business dealings with them, magiget nila or they will perceive na professional ka rin even on a personal basis. So how do we actually practice business phone etiquette? So this is in the field of business, not personal calls, ha? So field of business. Yeah. So first, try answering calls in the first 2 or 3 rings, no? Bakit? Nobody likes to wait, di ba? Kayo ba gusto yung maghintay? Di ba? Kapag you wait too much, especially when the call is before the call is answered, nagkakaroon ng feeling yung kausap na parang hindi naman siya importante, bakit hindi kagad sinasagot, no? I have actually an experience in the call center industry, and ang ruling sa amin noon is try to answer on the first ring, no? So unang ring pa lang sagutin mo na, hindi tayo minsan magbibilang patanawan 1, 2, 3. Dapat on the first ring sagutin na natin. Ano pa? The call should start with giving identification of yourself and your business to avoid any confusion. Lalo na, minsan, they dial the wrong number. Tapos, hello, gano'n. Tapos may pilit silang hinahanap na tao, di ba? So, if it, naiwasan natin yung mga gano'ng instances. If pagsagot mo pa lang, you already informed them of the company and who you are para aware sila na, ay, wait, wrong number pala yung natawagan ko. Di ba? Also, it gives your customers a more comfortable feeling kapag na-receive nila na parang very receptive ka when you answer the call. So, some example. Site tayo. Yan. So, kumari, it can be a company name or a department, and then, of course, your name. So, for example, you can say, thank you for calling customer service. This is Tina speaking. How may I help you? Diba? So, or I can say, thank you for calling Pampanga State Agricultural University. This is Tina speaking. How may I help you? Okay. So you can use that kind of welcome spiel, sabi nga natin. Okay. Sampulin nga natin, para tignan ko lang kung ano, any volunteers muna bago ako magtawag. Baka meron namang gustong mag-volunteer. Wala? Parang walang gusto mag-volunteer. Wala ako nakikita ng nag-raise na ng hands. Ayun. Meet on my end. Sige, try na lang natin. Si Angel Parido ba to? Angel. Can you try the spiel natin?
No po.
Sige. Sige, practice mo ng konti. sige. Angel, are you ready? Patry naman.
Yes.
You can use any company name, or a department, and then your name. Okay, yan. Ang bilis lang. Konti lang yan.
Wait lang.
Nag-modulate pa siya. Sige, habang nagre-ready siya, can we try Amerol?
Yes po.
Pasample naman, Amerol.
Kahit anong company po ba?
Yes, any company will do.
Okay. Yes, sir. Thank you for calling. Ay, tuloy ko na ba? Yung dire-diretso ba, ma'am?
Yes, sige.
Okay. Thank you for calling. This is Lala Rose Garden. This is your Amaral David Akov. How may I help you, sir?
Ayan. Galing na galing naman ni Amaral. Thank you for that. Ayan. At least, na sample niya, no? So it's very simple naman actually when you do your calls, 'di ba? Yan, daming fans si ano, si Amerol. Ayan. So it's very easy naman. Naturally, syempre we apply this when it comes to companies, 'di ba? Pero when it comes to personal calls, syempre hindi na tayo ganyan, 'di ba? You can either say or sometimes, 'di ba, we do that with the son's residence. Okay, pero ngayon kasi marami tayong instances na maraming scammers online, 'di ba? And even on the SIM. Kaya nga nagkaroon tayo ng mga SIM registry sa NTC because of that problem. Kaya nga ngayon kapag tumatawag, no, the advantage of using cell phones is may caller ID na tayo. However, may mga unregistered numbers tayo tapos tumatawag sa atin. So sometimes we are also hesitant to answer, 'di ba? So ano pa daw, aside from answering before it reaches 3 rings, identify yourself, what's next? Sabi niya, have a positive tone of voice. No? It always has a better response. Kaya nga, totoo naman, eh, kunwari, nagtumawag ka, ring-ring, tapos sasagot ka, thank you for calling customer service. Mrs. Tina, what do you want? Diba? Pag ganun yung response, parang, ay, nananakot, ay nangangain ng tao yung sumasagot. Diba? So, kailangan positive. Diba? Maganda yung parang, yung voice mo is very welcoming, no? So instead of saying thank you for calling, say thank you for calling. This is Tina speaking. How may I help you? Ganun, no? So it also builds a good rapport between you and your client. Okay, next. So friendly and cheerful body language. It is essential na kapag you are receiving calls or you are expecting call, lalo na kunwari nakahiga ka, it's proper that you sit down or have a good posture kasi yun din ang magdadala ng number one, ng boses mo, okay? And number two, on how you set the mood for yourself when you answer the call. Kasi kapag nakahiga, anong tendency? Tinatamad ka, ayaw mo mag-isip, ayaw mo mag-process ng information, di ba? As opposed when you have a cheerful and receptive na body language or ng posture, no, more likely, mas magiging maganda yung conversation ninyo. Ano pa? Be tactful. So, we have to be careful with the words that we use. We can be soft but firm in our communication. No, what we usually use is, or as much as possible, iniiwasan natin na ma-offend natin yung person on the other line. Although, minsan kasi, no, may mga ibang callers na sila mismo hindi sila aware at hindi rin sila ethical makipag-usap, 'di ba? There was one time na may tumatawag sa akin, nag-i-inquire siya of a person. I think hindi ko alam kung ginamit ba akong character reference ng mga estudyante for an application. Tapos it turns out na parang meron yatang pending na utang yung estudyante or what. And then ang sabi sa akin nung okay, sabi niya, can you please get in touch with me ganitong Mr. So-and-so, sabi niya ganyan, to avoid repeat calls and ganyan. So parang ang dating, ako pa yung mahaharas ng mga repetitive calls and contacts dahil lang doon sa kasalanan niya. No? So it could have been worded properly. No? Pwede niya sinabi na, if you can get in touch with Mr. So-and-so, so we may not be ganyan, na hindi na kayo maabala, and so on and so forth. But parang nasa choice of words din natin, how we can be more appealing sa kausap natin. Ano pa? Minimize interruptions and distractions. So katulad niya nung nasa picture, may kausap siya, pero at the same time, nagla-laptop siya. The tendency is when you are distracted with something else while you are talking to someone, you tend to what? Mute out yung information na binibigay niya. You're not paying attention. Wala yung focus mo dun sa call. No? So as much as possible, when you're talking to someone, go to a place na hindi ka madidistract, yung tahimik, at saka nobody will be interrupting your conversation. Ano pa? Active listening. Ayan. So hindi yung lumilipad-lipad yung utak natin, iba yung ginagawa natin, iba yung tinitignan natin. No? And it's much better if you would be taking notes. No, mag-take notes tayo. Okay, when we take notes and when we respond to our customer or our client or whoever we are talking to in the business, it affirms yung ating conversation. For example, may sinasabi siya, hindi yung tahimik ka lang. You confirm by saying yes, uh-huh, okay, noted, ganyan. Or, pag nag-active listening ka, you take notes and then you repeat what they said. Ah, so, sir, ang understanding ko po is, na-deliver na yung package, however, meron pong missing item. Ganon. Diba? So, you repeat what the customer is saying para alam niya na nakuha mo talaga yung information na sinasabi niya. Ano pa? Before placing the call on hold for any reason, ask permission from the person on the other end. No, pag i-hold mo siya, ipuput on hold mo siya, ask permission as to say, sir, ma'am, may put you on hold for about 5 minutes for, let me just verify your information. Okay? So, tanong muna, hindi yung bigla ka na lang nawala, naglaho, kala niya ginost mo na siya. Diba? So, you put the person on hold with his or her permission. And at the same time, don't forget to tell them why you're putting them on hold. Diba? Tsaka be careful with your words. Baka sabihin, may I hold you Oh, di makala niya, ihahug mo siya, di ba? So, ask for permission before you put the person on hold and tell them the reason why you're putting them on hold. Okay. Ano pa? Mati na lang to. Ensure all the needs and queries of the caller are solved before ending the call. Ibig sabihin, you affirm, you ask kung meron pa bang kailangan, kung na-affirm na ba. Oh. So, kumbaga, the best thing that you can do this to sum up the call. No? So, we say na, so as I understand that the delivery was, or the package was delivered, however, there was a missing item. So, what I'll be doing for you, sir or ma'am, is that I will be tracking where the other items will be and we'll get back to you and we'll call back to you. No? So, ganon, di ba? So, after that, you can already ask, is there anything else I can do, sir, to help you with this situation? O, di ba? At least, dun pa lang, na-resolve na. And you can ask kung meron pa ba siyang kailangan na, tawag dito, kailangan na, na tulong. Yan. So, finally, when you bid goodbye to your customer, to your client, or to your business partner, whoever you are talking to in the business, thank you. O, no? Kailangan i-thank natin yung tao. Huwag natin kalimutan yun, no? Gratitude. No, so be pleasant, sabi nga ni nila Sir Frank kanina, no. Make that good impression when it comes to your customers, no. And let the person hang up. Hindi ikaw yung unang magbababa. Hayaan mo siya yung magbaba kasi baka minsan may maaalala siya tapos may ihahabol siya. Nabatay mo na, 'di ba? And it's more courteous to let the caller, no, especially customer on this end to do the hang up. So ensure that there are no accidental hang-ups, no? Huwag yung be careful how you handle your phone or in such a way na baka mapindot mo yung end call. Baka sabihin ni customer, ang bastos-bastos naman nung kausap ko. Diba? So, sampulin ulit natin. Okay? So, balikan natin. Again, thank you for calling customer service. Is there anything else I can help you with? Pag sinabi niya, wala na. Okay? Thank you very much for your call and we appreciate that you have air your concern with us. And you hope you have a good day. Diba? So, ganun nyo, i-end yung call ninyo. Okay. So, I believe that's it. Ayan. Thank you very much. And I will introduce to you si Sir Aldrin, who will continue the